Hi friends, this side Priya from Biology Concepts. So today I am going to discuss one of the very basic topic of cell biology, that is the plasma membrane. So plasma membrane, basically it is a sheet like structure. As you can see in this slide, it is a sheet like structure that will separate internal environment of the cell from the external environment. So all the biological membranes are 5 to 8 nanometer thick and also control the flow of molecules across the membrane. So this is the biological membrane. You can easily see these are the proteins, and this is the lipid bilayer, and this is the carbohydrate chains. This is the cell membrane, outside of the cell, inside of the cell, that is the cytoplasm. Yes. So what we are going to discuss in this video, it is very important to know, students. So first, we are going to discuss, do all living cells have plasma membrane? This is the question. So I will tell the question, I will tell answer also in this video. So what are the principal components of the plasma membrane? Proteins of plasma membrane, which is found in plasma membrane, or the cell membrane. What is the basic difference between cell membrane and plasma membrane? And what are the characteristics of the plasma membrane? Selective permeability, it is one of the basic or important property of biological membranes. Plasma membrane, they are also known as biological membranes. So next topic will be prokaryotic plasma membrane versus eukaryotic plasma membrane, and at last we will discuss about fluid mosaic model of the cell membranes, which was given by Singer and Nicholson, and finally functions of plasma membrane. So let us start one by one. So my first question was, do all cells have plasma membrane? So all cells have an outer plasma membrane. You can see that regulates not only what enters the cell, but also how much of the any substance comes in. Means this plasma membrane, it will allow how much substance will go and which molecule will go inside or not. So, and unlike prokaryotes, eukaryotic cells also possesses internal membranes that in case they are organelles and control the exchange of essential cell components. So this is the question, all cells are having plasma membrane. Okay. So next topic is principal components of the plasma membrane. So lipids, basically phospholipids and cholesterol, proteins and the carbohydrates. They make the plasma membrane and they are attached to some of the lipids and proteins. And a phospholipid is a lipid made up of glycerol, two fatty acid tails and a phosphate linked head groups. So here I make a note, phospholipids make up of three basic components of the cell membrane. This arrangement of phospholipid molecules make up the lipid bilayer. So the phospholipids of the cell membrane are arranged in a double layer called lipid bilayer. That is why it is called lipid bilayer. The hydrophilic phosphate head are always arranged so that they are near to water. Okay, so next slide is all about we have discussed this question. So next slide is all about proteins in the plasma membrane. In plasma membrane, a protein helps in providing the support and shape to the cell. There are three types of protein which is found in plasma membrane, that are cell membrane receptor proteins, transport proteins and glycoproteins. So you can write a definition, what are cell membrane receptor? Basically they are receptors which will receive the hormones or the neurotransmitters and other signaling molecules. And transport proteins, they will help in transporting molecules, and as the name suggests, transportation. So glycoproteins, it help in cell to cell communication. So what are the basic characteristics of the plasma membrane? It is made up of two layers, made up of layers of phospholipids, Plasma membrane has many proteins. Plasma membrane regulates the entry and exit of cell. Many molecules across the cell membrane by diffusion and osmosis. Fundamental structure of the plasma membrane is phospholipid bilayer. It forms a stable barrier between the two aqueous compartments. So the protein present in the plasma membrane, they act as a pump, channel, receptors, enzyme or structural components. Yes. So I have told you so many biological properties of the biological membrane. That is one of the important properties, selective permeability. This is very important. And one more property, that is self-sealing property. You can write self-sealing property. And one is flexibility also. So we are going to discuss here selective permeability, which is very important. Due to this property, cells can retain or exclude molecules. In one line you can say they are called semi-permeable, meaning that only certain molecules can pass through them. Water, oxygen and carbon dioxide can easily pass through the membrane. Generally, ions in the polar molecules cannot pass through the membrane. They must go through specific channels or pores in the membrane instead of freely diffuse. As you know, inside nature of the plasma membrane is hydrophobic. So in membranes, hydrophobic regions of both the monolayers, they face to each other and they form a membrane core of the membrane, whereas hydrophilic head group face opposite direction. Okay. So how cell membrane differ from plasma membrane? Cell membrane is a type of plasma membrane that encloses a cell and it all content including cytoplasm and organelles. Organelles, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, nucleus, I think you all know. The plasma membrane can be found forming the membrane of the other organelles in addition to the cell membrane. Organelle plasma membranes may differ from cell membrane. Both the cell membrane and another plasma membrane have selective permeability and also control the transportation. And the cell membrane is involved in cytokinesis, that is the process of cytoplasm division during the cell division, while other cell membranes of the cells are not involved specifically in this process. So this is one of the very important figure we are going to discuss. Fluid mosaic model of the structure of the cell membranes. Basically, it was given by Singer and Nicholson. The model is called fluid mosaic. Why it is called fluid mosaic model? Because according to the Singer and Nicholson, biological membrane, it consists of back-to-back arrangement of two lipid bilayers. This is the lipid bilayer and the proteins are distributed in the membrane as a mosaic. Proteins are distributed as a mosaic. So biological membranes, they are primarily consist of lipids. Basic, they consist of lipids. So individual lipid molecules present within the monolayer are freely diffused within the plane due to the hydrophobic attraction. This is the hydrophobic attraction. So movement of the individual lipid molecule within the membrane represents fluid state. That is why movement of fluid state, that is why it is called fluid. And the proteins are represented in mosaic model. That is why mosaic-like structure, that is why fluid mosaic model. So these both character of the membrane justify fluid mosaic model of the membrane. Okay. So here some of the key features I have given. So phospholipid molecules form bilayer. Phospholipids are fluid and move laterally. Peripheral proteins which are found on the periphery are bound to the either the inner or outer surface. And the integral protein, they permeate the surface of the membrane. And the membrane is a fluid mosaic of the phospholipids and proteins. And the proteins can move laterally along the membrane. So I told you this is the hydrophobic region. This is the hydrophilic region. This is the lipid phospholipid bilayer. Phospholipid bilayer, you can say. These are the hydrophobic tails. Alpha helix protein is found. Surface protein or peripheral proteins, you can say. Cholesterol is also found, glycolipids, peripheral proteins which are found on the boundary or the periphery, you can say. Filaments of cytoskeletal protein channels are there, globular proteins and glycoproteins. So why they are called fluid mosaic? Because mosaic, different proteins are embedded in the phospholipids. And why fluid? Proteins and phospholipids can move freely in the membrane. So many times people ask a question that why the model is called fluid mosaic. You can write this point that the fluid, what is the meaning of the fluid here? Proteins and lipids, they can move freely. And what is the meaning of mosaic? Different proteins embedded in the phospholipids. So this slide is all about prokaryotic plasma membrane versus eukaryotic plasma membrane. So prokaryotic plasma membrane basically it composed of phospholipid bilayer with embedded proteins. In the middle of the bilayer, the fatty acids of the phospholipids are found, which is called as hydrophobic region. I told you earlier, prokaryotic cells have multiple plasma membrane. In prokaryotes, plasma membrane are responsible for controlling the entry and exit of the cell. While on the other hand, eukaryotic plasma membrane is phospholipid bilayer containing proteins and carbohydrates to the proteins and histidinol. It is a fluid phospholipid bilayer embedded with the proteins and the glycoproteins. And the phospholipid bilayer is arranged in such a manner that they form the center of the membrane. They also contain histidinol. You have to learn this point. Esterols, which makes the membrane less permeable and help to stabilize the membrane and add to the rigidity of the membrane. So what are the biological properties? I told you fluid mosaic model. I told you fluid mosaic model. Some properties I want to tell you once again. The membranes are dynamic in nature. As you all know, all the biological membranes, they are asymmetric. As you can't able to find the symmetry, that is why they are called asymmetric. And biological membranes are selective permeable, I told you. And individual lipid and protein, they are diffusing laterally. You can write this point. And the carbohydrate, they are present mostly on the outer face of the plasma membrane. They are present on the outer face. That is why this is the carbohydrates, I told you, in the form of glycolipids and glycoproteins. So plasma membranes are assembly of lipid. In one line, you can say, you have to understand or remember this key point that all the biological membranes, they are the assembly of the lipid, protein, whereas carbohydrates are present on the outer surface of the plasma membrane. Hence, membrane contain lipid, proteins as well as carbohydrates. So many membrane lipids are there. I think you all know phospholipids, glycolipids, esterols, phospholipids. They can be further classified into glycerophospho and phosphosphingolipids. And what about glycolipids? They can be classified into glycosphingo and glyceroglycolipids. And esterol, they can also be classified. So I will give a separate video on membrane lipids. So this plasma membrane video and that video, you can interconnect to each other. Membrane lipids, basically it is a part of biochemistry, membrane lipids. I will give all the classification of membrane lipids. Now I want to tell you people one thing more. So distribution of lipids in the membrane, some lipids are present on the outer face and some lipids are present on the inner face. So inner face, you can easily learn. Inner face lipids are phosphatidylserine, phosphatidylethanolamine and phosphatidylinositol. Once again, I am repeating, phosphatidylserine, phosphatidylethanolamine, phosphatidylinositol. And outer surface lipids are phosphatidylcholine and sphingo. Mild. These are the lipids which are present, and some there is some importance of the cholesterol also. Cholesterol, basically these are esterols. I told you it is one of the classification of the membrane lipid. I will give a separate video on membrane lipids. So at last I want to discuss one thing more. What are the functions of the plasma membrane? It separates the content of the cell from outside and regulates what enter and exit the cell. Plasma membrane plays a vital role in protecting the integrity of the interior of the cell. It also serves as a base of attachment for the cytoskeleton in some organisms. The cell membrane is primarily composed of protein and lipids, I told you earlier. And the lipid bilayer is semi-permeable, which allows only selected molecules to diffuse across the membrane. So I hope you all have understood my video. Thank you, friends. So if you feel any query, you can write me in comment box or you can directly contact through my Gmail or YouTube channel in my comment box. I hope you can easily solve the problems which I have asked earlier in any competitive exams. If you feel any problem, you can write me in comment box. Surely, friends, I will reply as soon as possible. If you like the video, please hit the like button and share this video as more as possible. And please subscribe to my channel, friends. Thank you once again. I hope we will meet soon. Thank you, friends. Bye-bye.